Sony charts not one, but five games in the top 10 of the latest NPD results, but that's not the most surprising thing. Plus, Netflix Datamine could suggest a partnership with PlayStation, and Jim Ryan had some interesting things to say about the future of PlayStation games in a recent interview. All this and much, much more in today's edition of the Saltiest PlayStation News Report. Let's get into it. What's up, PlayStation Nation? In today's first story, the latest NPD results are out for the month of June, and PlayStation had an amazing month when it comes to software and games. Not only did they chart five, not one, not two, not three, five games in the top 10 of the best-selling video games, they also had some other amazing statistics come out when it comes to the platform. So without further ado, let's get into it. Top 10 selling video games of June 2021. The five games that come from PlayStation are Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart, comes in at number one again. This game is smashing all expectations, and the sales of this game are phenomenal. I'm just going to give you a peek into what's going on behind the scenes. According to Benji Sells, who tracks this kind of info, Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart had the biggest launch ever for the franchise in the US via NPD. Its launch month more than doubled the Ratchet & Clank sales for 2016's PS4 game in terms of dollar sales. What's interesting to me in breaking down these statistics, number one, there was a lot of haters that came out and said, oh, you guys are releasing a game on PlayStation 5 only? That's limiting your sales. Why not put it on the PlayStation 4 as well? The sales will suffer. Well, I guess in retrospect, they didn't suffer because this game continues to do phenomenally. This game was released in the beginning of a console's life cycle where the user base was low, and it's still doubling the sales of the previous game on the PlayStation 4 in 2016 when that had a bigger market share. This also tells you that the PlayStation 5 supply is getting better because people are able to buy the PlayStation 5, so they're snatching up copies of Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart. I'm very happy for Insomniac Games. They're smashing it out of the park. The other four games that charted were MLB The Show, which is now a multiplat. That was number three. Marvel's Spider-Man Miles Morales charted at four. Ghost of Tsushima charted at nine, making its return after the announcement of the expansion. And Final Fantasy VII Remake charted at number 10. One of the most shocking things to come out from the NPD by far is the fact that the Xbox Series X and S was the number one platform in the US in terms of dollar sales. The Switch led in units. It's the biggest June ever for Xbox brand in history, breaking previous records set back in 2011. Props to them. Competition is good in the game industry, and I'm all for it, but in terms of sales overall, the PlayStation 5 is dominating almost 2-1 with Xbox, but props to them for having a good month. But that's the NPD results for the month of June. What do you guys think? Five games from PlayStation charting top 10. And what do you think of Xbox taking the number one platform spot in June in terms of dollar sales? Are you down with the competition? Let's talk about it. In other news, it's kind of a strange story. I don't know how to think about this. Netflix Datamine could suggest a partnership with PlayStation. PlayStation content could be making the leap to Netflix, according to a recent Datamine. Recently, Netflix has not been shy in its desire to jump into the video game space, recently announcing that the streaming giant will be expanding to make game content. But like I said, a recent Datamine suggests that a partnership could also be forming with PlayStation to bring some of the biggest PlayStation brands to Netflix in some form. Dataminer Steve Moser appears to have uncovered PlayStation brand imagery and content in the Netflix app code. Moser shared the information via a tweet, which includes images of both Ghost of Tsushima box art and some PlayStation 5 controllers. It's not clear exactly what this means for Netflix and PlayStation, but if there's a new partnership between Netflix and PlayStation, it could see Ghost of Tsushima content come from the streaming service Netflix in some form or another. If this does happen, which it looks like it probably will, it's not the first time that Sony and Netflix have made a partnership. Both of these companies agreed to a deal earlier, which means that Sony Pictures will come to Netflix first after their theatrical run. So this might be a continuation of these two companies teaming up when it comes to the entertainment space. As far as Sony goes, they've been very vocal about wanting to do more with their franchises outside of games. gaming. We already know of The Last of Us TV show starring Pedro Pascal, and a Ghost of Tsushima movie has been greenlit. So they're trying to get into other areas of entertainment with their IPs. But as far as this partnership goes, I have no idea what's going to come from this. I think Netflix jumping into gaming is going to flop hard, and I kind of don't want PlayStation associated with that. I don't know how they're going to make the crossover between streaming movies and TV shows to putting game content out there. They've already tried to do stuff with games like interactive content. If you guys remember this or not, they had these interactive stories through productions such as Black Mirror and Bandersnatch, which adopted a sort of choose your own adventure approach to storytelling, but it did not really work out, in my opinion. I'm not sure how the company plans to get in the gaming space, but regardless, I don't think this is a good idea. But I want to hear from you guys. What do you think of this data mine leak, Netflix Sony partnership, potentially bringing some PlayStation brands to Netflix in some form and another? Let's talk about it. And finally, in the last bit of news, CEO Jim Ryan, whatever you want to call him, he's been busy with some interviews. He had some interesting things to say about PlayStation games going forward and in terms of quality that I thought will break down a little bit here, because it's kind of controversial what he said about quality and games. So without further ado, let's talk about what he had to say about AAA development. He said that the PlayStation studios will focus on AAA development while smaller games will come from partner indie developers. He made these comments in an interview with TMT Post. This question was posed to Jim Ryan after they talked about PlayStation prioritizing development of AAA blockbusters, no longer wanting to develop smaller games. His answer, Sony's going to do both, but it's also clearly demarcate the two. Ryan says that while first-party PlayStation studios are going to focus on making big-budget AAA games, Sony will also keep partnering with smaller independent studios to ensure that PlayStation maintains a healthy stream of more small-scale experiences. Honestly, I love this approach from PlayStation. They know the value of a big AAA blockbuster game. They've shown this with releases of Ghost of Tsushima, The Last of Us 2, God of War 2018, Spider-Man PlayStation 4, Ratchet & Clank, Rift Apart. The list goes on and on. Jim Ryan said that he wants these to be like big releases of movies, like The Avengers. It needs to be an event. But at the same time, they know the value of smaller independent games, and that's why they contract outside with these up-and-coming studios, these new studios like Jade Raymond's Haven Studios, to make other different type of games. In essence, you can have your cake and eat it too. Later in the interview, this is where Jim Ryan said something that's pretty, it's kind of controversial in a sense. PlayStation CEO Jim Ryan said it's better to wait and have a great game than to rush and have a game that's just okay. Players only remember best games rather than okay games. If it is the best game, players may want a sequel and they will also want to buy a sequel, but no one really cares about a game that is only okay. Shots fired. Jim Ryan wants all the smoke, doesn't he? Honestly, this is a bold statement that players only remember the best games rather than okay games. To be honest, I like what he's saying here. He's putting an emphasis on making great quality games, game of the year type bangers. But honestly, you can't expect every studio to produce a 90 plus Metacritic game and have a game of the year style game. It's just impossible to do that, even though they've come close to that. And honestly, when it comes to entertainment mediums like movies and television, I remember a lot of mediocre films and mediocre television shows. And even in the video game space, I remember a good amount of mediocre games that I enjoyed for different reasons, and I'll always remember those. So I don't know if the statement holds water 100%, if that makes sense. But anyway, I gotta get your guys' take. What do you think of Jim Ryan's comments? What do you think about the big PlayStation studios focusing on AAA blockbusters and hiring outside for those indie smaller projects? And what do you have to say about his comments about gamers only remember great quality games? Let's talk about it. But anyways, that's it for today's edition of the Saltiest PlayStation News Report. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I enjoyed making it. If you guys are new, make sure to slap the like button and subscribe. Hit the bell icon so you stay up to date with all things PlayStation and PlayStation 5. I hope you guys have a great day. Have fun gaming. And as always, stay salty, my friends.